Hello mga kababayan! Happy, happy new year! As promised, ito, gumawa kami ng special video about some of the pathways na pwede nyo i-consider when you want to enter Canada. So, right now, we are recording this video, December
30.
December 30 dito sa Calgary. So, I think right now sa Philippine, December 31. So, new year na new year. Happy New Year sa inyong lahat and we wish everyone a prosperous 2023 and may that year be a year of blessing, restoration, good health, and sana bumaba na yung mga presyo, lalo na yung sibuyas. Kasi at this moment, alam namin yung nangyayari dyan sa mga bilihin. So, ayun, may we all have an abundant 2023. Yay! Okay, so my husband Ronald, so I'm so happy that he's already joining us sa video na to. So mahal, ano yung i-discuss natin in this vlog?
Will you please repeat it?
For this vlog, ang i-discuss namin is yung mga pathways that you can consider if you're planning to go here in Canada.
Nung nag-search kami, parang there are 6 pathways that you can consider. Pero ang i-discuss namin, these are the pathways that are very common and parang somehow pinakamadali, di ba? Na pwede na yung i-consider when you want to go here to Canada. So first is, paano mag-discuss ang una?
Bola lang yan!
First is the student pathway.
It's a student pathway. Siya yung i-discuss na yun kasi siya ay... Yung pathway na pinasok namin dito ay student.
Right. Yes.
So, okay.
So in generic terms, student pathway, ito yung pathway wherein yung tao ay nag-a-apply na mag-move to Canada in the duration of the study. So, with the main objective of completing a program in a school that is located here in Canada. So, yun yung pathway we're in. Compared to other pathways, you need much more funds to support you. Kasi basically, maglalabas ka ng pera para i-sustain or i-support yung pag-aaral mo dito sa Canada. And,
Just sustain, di ba, daddy? But also yung tuition that you need to pay sa school.
That's right.
In the student pathway, what we know, di ba, is that you have to choose a province or una muna talaga ano yung course, di ba? And in our case, parang sa katulad niya, ang pinili niyang course is Bachelor in...
Petroleum Engineering Technology. So,
yes.
Yung selection ng course, it should tie up doon sa narrative na gusto nyong i-present sa application nyo. So like for myself, I'm a mechanical engineer by profession sa Philippines, pero I'm in the oil and gas industry. So it doesn't make sense for me to take a diploma in mechanical engineering technology kasi I've completed the program in the Philippines already and gained relevant experience. So ang next na appropriate na course na kunin ko when I thought about it is yung industry where I am in, which is in oil and gas. So that is why I chose yung petroleum engineering technology. At the same time, ito yung course that can open up opportunities for me here in Alberta, Canada. Thinking process para mag-arrive dun sa decision na yun is really based on sa circumstance ko. So, ang tip namin sa inyo is really to think about yung, syempre, yung specific circumstances that you are in so that you will be able to select yung course na makakatulong sa inyo in building your career here in Canada or whatever goal that you may have. At the same time, it makes sense when you craft yung storyline dun sa statement of purpose dun sa application nyo.
Yes.
Kasi it has to make sense to the visa officer who will be reviewing your application.
Yes, kasi marami tayo na-encounter din, daddy, di ba, sa groups na ang dami refusals, nakakailang letters sila to justify why they are having that course. So, sa kanya, sa case ni Ron, talagang pinag-isipan para mas madaling mag-create ng letter, mas madaling i-justify kung bakit mo kailangan dito mag-study, bakit ito yung course na kukunin mo. And then at the same time, pag consistent kasi yung information, mas madali ang chances na ma-approve talaga yung application. So in our case, we are very thankful din sa friends namin na si Len and Alex ko, na una na sila dito a few months before, diba? So they really helped us in crafting our statement of purpose. And sa case ko, when work permit, letter of intent. So, if you are a husband and wife, yun yung letters na kailangan yung ipasa sa immigration para makasama mo yung spouse mo. And if you have children, sa case naman ng mga anak namin, they are under temporary resident visa. So, TRV ang visa nila. So, may letter din yun. There is also letter of intent for the children. So, kailangan, pag nag-craft kayo, pasadahan na natin ang saglit, di ba, Di? Pag nag-craft kayo ng letter, statement of purpose ni husband, letter of intent ni wife, and letter of intent for the children, dapat consistent yon alongside with the attachment. So, thank you to our friends Alex and Len for helping us kasi one time lang na-approve ka agad yung application namin.
And, so, siguro before we go to the other options, so we wrap up yung student pathway.
Yes.
And siguro what yung key message namin sa inyo when you decide to go that route is to really be strategic about it. Kasi kami, yung selection ng school, ng province, all that, is tied up to the longer term plan that we have, which is why we chose here in Calgary, Alberta, because andito yung industry that offer a lot of opportunities, not just for me, but also for my wife. So, yung duration ng study is also something that we look at where we think na enough yung time to be invited for the PR application.
Yes.
Kasi, so, you have to be strategic about this.
Yes. Kasi after ng student pathway, hindi ka pa kasi citizen dito, hindi ka pa rin permanent resident So, may mga courses kasi they offer the postgraduate work permit, yung tinatawag nilang PGWP. So, pag after mo kasi matapos yung program, pwede mo makuha ang permit na yon, which will grant you an extension to stay here in Canada. Mm-hmm. And you could grab that opportunity to apply for a permanent residence. So, yun yung goal ng karamihan sa katulad namin na ganito yung pathway. So, sa case ko naman, I am an open work permit holder. So, my profession is a medical technologist in the Philippines. So, ang ginawa ko is that for me to be able to practice my profession here, habang nandun na pala nga ako sa Philippines, inasikaso ko na kung ano yung mga requirements ng isang medtech para mag-practice dito sa Canada. So, ako, next month, in February, I will be taking my CSMLS licensure exam. So, once I pass this exam, with God's grace, I will be able to practice my profession as a medical technologist. So, yun, kinoconnect ko siya sa sinasabi ni Ron na you have to be strategic. Kasi, katulad ko, sa case ko, ako, ang medtech naman kasi, right now, we are in demand, no, kahit sa ang province in Canada. Pero kasi, since si Ron, kinoconsider namin yung option talaga sa Alberta dahil ang Alberta is the seat of oil and gas industry in Canada. So, kahit na may invitation ako sa ibang provinces, mas inuna ko yung Alberta kasi nga, dito, I can work at the same time siya din. He can grow in his career. So, it's very important for you as husband and wife to be very strategic and to think well about kung saan province kayo. Right? Okay.
Yep.
So, I think that's all. That's a brief overview of the student pathway. And the next pathway that we will be discussing about is that yung paggawa ng express entry profile. So, express entry is a pathway na kahit sino, di ba, pwede ka gumawa ng profile. However, ang express entry kasi may scores. May tinatawag na CRS. That's the scoring system para malaman kung ang score mo is pasok ba doon sa rounds of invitation. Kailangan may ma-meet kang certain score. Like, for example, ngayon yung mga score range is 400 60, di ba? 460.
Or higher.
Or higher. So, depende. Ang scores kasi, if you could search sa IRCC website, merong ano yan, merong category. So, depende sa work experience mo, sa education, ang age nagmamatter din. Kasi, katulad ko, last time, ang score ko is around 433, ang CRS points ko. Pero, nung nag-age lang ako, 1 year lang. Bumaba na siya ng a couple of points.
Anong cute? Ako na ang cute dito!
So, nagmamatter din yon yung age talaga. So, the younger, the better. So, for those na nasa 30s pa lang or 20s, it's a good consideration, no, if you want to enter here. And then, ang score, pwede din siyang ma-affect ng kanilang experience. So, if you have experience of working, may points din yon. So, mataas din yung points. Kaya ang iba, di ba, for example, iba katulad si Ron or ako, may express entry profile kami. Once makapag-work kami dito, we can record that to our profile and then automatically, we will gain another set of points. So, that's the time where kung masaktuhan ng IRCC na yung points mo pasok, pwede kang ma-invite for permanent residence. Yes. And then, in connection with the express entry, merong tinatawag na provincial nomination program. So, this is the program in every province of Canada wherein they invite, no? They just invite. Depende kasi sa category nila eh. May certain time na pasok yung score mo or pag ano kasi may question kasi dyan sa express entry eh, kung sa ang province mo prefer, di ba, mag-stay. So, if yung province na yun, naghahanap siya ng, for example, someone with your profession na parang tingin nila, you can be an asset doon sa industries nila, sa economy nila, economically. So, they could invite you. So, ano yung provincial nomination? Ng ibang provinces, meron silang expression of interest like sa Saskatchewan. You will just apply for that. You will send your requirements and then apply as an expression of interest. Tapos, if pasok yung score mo, kasi may scoring din yan eh, they could invite you for provincial nomination. And then, may requirements din po yun. Ang dami ding mga papel. So, kakailanganin nyo, including the proof of funds. So, ang proof of funds, nakadepende po yan sa kung isa ka lang, dalawa kayo, or family kayo. So, it's also another consideration to prepare. No, kung before ka mag-apply sa express entry, before ka mag-apply for provincial nomination, before ka mag-apply, whatever pathway, you need to ensure that you have enough funds to sustain yourselves as a family, as an individual, or as a couple. Okay, so may mga commercial din kami mo kasi may mga anak kami. We're recording this while they're awake kasi ito lang yung time namin right now, no? So, yun, it's ano siya, maganda din itong provincial nomination kasi once ma-nominate ka and makapasa ka and approved ka, eligible ka for nomination, papasok yun doon sa may IRCC. Pag nag-invite, ang ano, pag nagbunutan na, kasi parang ano yan eh, parang loto, no? Parang raffle. So, pag nagbunutan, nakapasok yung score mo, automatically, PR ka na nun. So, congratulations! So,
napag-get mo yung points?
Yes, may points siya.
600. 600 points
usually
agad.
Usually, 600. Oh, yes. 600 points agad yun pag may provincial nomination ka. So, imagine ha, if meron kang express entry profile na may 400 points ka, let's say. Tapos, na-invite ka. Na-eligible ka ng province. Plus 600 yun. So, 1,000 ang points mo. So, more chances of, ano talaga, mabubunod ka sa next round ng invitations ni Canada to be a permanent resident. And then, lastly, after the provincial nomination, meron pa tayong tinatawag na yung work, diba?
LMIA.
LMIA. So, ito yung sa ibang mga individuals, daddy, na na-invite para magtrabaho dito. Yes. Yeah. Pero ang iba kasi, sa pagkakaalam ko, may certain duration lang din sila ng stay dito, diba? But, if may ibang employers that are willing to sponsor you, pwede ka din talagang maging permanent resident. So, it's still a good advantage for those na may LMIA kasi if you will have a Canadian experience, additional points pa rin yun sa express entry profile mo. So, yun. So, magandang ano din siya, magandang pathway. Pero depende kasi talaga sa work. May mga work kasi na hindi regulated. May mga work din na regulated. So, may mga ingay talaga kami. So, pasensya na. Yun, but ang maganda din sa LMIA is that kung makukuha ka ng employer, at kadalasan naman kasi ang mga employer kasi are very supportive. Yes. And kung maganda yung performance mo sa work, pwede ka nilang i-absorb, sponsoran ka para permanently makapag-resign ka dito.
Although, mahirap yung ano eh, di ba?
Oo, mahirap kasi ma-invite sa LMIA. Mahirap ma-invite kasi we also tried that.
Masyado kang mareklamo, gusto mo na umuwi?
Kasi pag once may express entry profile ka na, once may express entry profile ka na, anong tawag doon? Wala na tuloy ako. Once may express entry profile ka na, may ano yan eh, may job bank wherein you can search for jobs connected to your profession. Pero ang hirap din mag-apply kasi karamihan sa mga employers dito, they also require certificates. Like sa case namin, hindi siya pwede kasi hindi pa siya engineer. Sa akin naman, hindi naman ako medtech pa. So,
regulated profession.
Pag-regulated yung profession. So, kailangan talaga, if regulated yung profession, dumaan ka doon sa mga societies or regulatories ng profession. Yeah. So, I think that's for now about the pathways. So,
yeah, so this is just an overview of those pathways. Yep. Yung step by step, we will create a separate videos for that para masundan nyo yung application process.
Yes.
But for now, hopefully, we are able to give you some tips and some insights on how to be strategic in your application and yes, how you will make it work for you, not just for you to come here, but also to sustain yourselves here and establish
Amen.
Yourself.
Kasi importante talaga ang pag-sustain sa sarili. So, number one yun, no, na for me, ha, it's a number one factor that you have to keep in mind if you want to go here kasi kailangan hindi lang yung may mapapakita ka na pera, no, but kumbaga ang pera na yun magagamit mo rin once tumating ka dito. So yun.
Yeah. So that's it for now.
So thank you so much for listening to us.
Yeah.
And God bless kung meron ka mang ongoing application ngayon. And happy new year sa
inyo. Happy new year.